Hi you guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Avery. I live in New York City and I post daily vlogs and fashion content and all of that good stuff. But I'm sitting with you guys right now on January, what day is it? 15th, I think? January 16th? Honestly, I have no idea what a day is, but it's a Sunday and we're going into the third week of January. And I feel like time's already flying by in the new year, but it's 2024, so I wanted to sit down and do just a little sit down talk video about all of my new year's resolutions and kind of what I'm hoping to accomplish, what my goals are in 2024. I feel like 2023 was a crazy year for me. I feel like it was just like very up and down and so much happened. I got a brand new job at like my dream company. So I basically just got like my dream job and that changed kind of the trajectory of what I was thinking was going to happen in 2024. I've lived in New York for 4.5 years now, and this summer my lease was ending and I kind of felt like my time in New York was coming to an end and I wanted to move somewhere else and try something different. But I ended up getting a sublease for a few months and then ended up getting my dream job. So I decided to stay in New York and I'm very happy I did. I ended up moving out and living in my own apartment, which we are in right now, my own studio apartment. It's my first time living alone. So just a lot of different things happening in 2023. Living alone, moving to a whole new neighborhood of New York, and getting a brand new job. And I've been in my new job now for about like 3 months. So yeah, just so much changed. I'm hoping 2024 I can really figure out what I want and kind of just like get in a good routine. I feel like I've kind of just been all over the place for the past like honestly like 6 or 8 months, because I just have like my head's been all over the place, my emotions have been all over the place. I didn't really know what I was gonna do, and now I finally feel like I'm settled and just can get into like a good routine and good habits. So kind of wanted to talk through what my resolutions were. I didn't really do resolutions per se, but I did ins and outs, which I think was like a little bit of a trend this year, but I really liked it because I wanted to like more so just like list out positive things that I wanted to bring into my life rather than say like, oh, I'm gonna work out 5 times a week or I'm gonna like stick to this certain resolution. So yeah, I just thought we could talk through my list of ins and outs, and hopefully it gives you guys a little bit of motivation and maybe some ideas for things that you want to have happen in your year too. I'm sorry if this camera is shaking. I have you propped up in my bed right now. And I feel like every time I'm like talking or moving around, it's shaking. So don't, yeah, I'm sorry. I'm gonna try not to like do anything sudden. So yeah, let's get into it. I actually filmed this last night, but I was filming it at sunset and at first the lighting looked really good, and then it got so dark, so decided to refilm it. But I already kind of know what I'm gonna say now, and I feel like last night's video was a little bit all over the place. So let's get into it. We're gonna start with the ins, because obviously we're gonna start with the positives. So my first in is waking up at 5:30. I might not wake up at 5:30 every day, but I just want to start implementing waking up earlier again. I already am a morning person, so I say I wake up pretty early already, but I don't have to be in the office until 9:30. So if I wake up at like 5:30, 6 or every day, I feel like that'll give me a really good morning routine. Back when I lived in the Lower East Side a couple years ago, that was 2 years ago now. I lived there for 2 years with 2 roommates. I just felt like that was my prime, like, I felt physically the best I ever have, and I felt mentally probably the best I ever had. And I was going back and thinking back to that time and like, what were some of the things that I did and what were some of the habits that I had that made me feel so good? And I feel like one thing was I was waking up early and I had a really, really good morning routine. So I'm trying to get back into that, and I feel like I've done a pretty good job these past few weeks, honestly. So I've been waking up around 6, like 5:36, and I've been working out, I've been going on a walk or getting my steps in. I just got a walking pad, actually, so just like a mini treadmill. So I've been getting my steps in, doing a 30-minute like strength workout normally, or Pilates, and then I sit down and I journal, and I might do like a 5-minute meditation. I make my breakfast, have my coffee, get ready. So it's just been a really nice little routine so far, and I really want to keep up waking up early, because I feel like it just gives me, when I go into the office, I feel like having that couple of hours in the mornings like really sets up my day for success. I find the days that I sleep in and just like have to immediately get up and get ready for work, my whole day is thrown off. So that's my spiel about waking up early. I know it can be hard, but I like to plug in my phone across the room before I go to bed. And that way when my alarm goes off, I have to like get up physically and go turn it off. And that way, like, I'm already out of bed, so I'm already gonna be up. So it's just like a little trick if you guys are struggling. Next up is sauna sessions. I've always loved the sauna. I'm a big sauna steam room girly, but I unfortunately don't belong to a gym right now, trying to save money in 2024. So instead I bought a sauna blanket off Amazon, which I'd wanted one from this brand called Higher Dose for a really long time, but it's like $500, I think. So I ordered a dupe basically off Instagram or off Amazon for, it was like $130, I think, and I love it. It's just this big giant like blanket suit thing that you sit in and you zip yourself up in it, and you can choose how long you want to be in it and what the temperature is. And I just sit there, scroll on my phone, like respond to emails, watch TV, and it's just so easy and nice to just lay there. And like I sweat a lot when I get in there, so it's really nice. I feel like it's really detoxifying, and I want to make a goal of doing that 4 times a week, so it just makes me feel better. Next is meal prepping. Similar to when I lived in the Lower East Side, and even last year, I was really good at meal prepping, and I've definitely gotten off my game. I don't live near a Trader Joe's or a grocery store that I love. I am kind of close to Whole Foods, so I should just start going there, but I've just been off my game with grocery shopping and meal prepping, so I want to get back into that. I want to spend Sundays going to the grocery store, planning out meals, and meal prepping. I used to be really good about, like I said, prepping out like lunches and dinner recipes, and then you just automatically have like a good healthy meal to eat. And I love going on Pinterest and searching and finding like fun recipes, and like just having that motivation to like try different healthy stuff. So I want to get back into that. Next up, a tough one, more dating. I want to go on more dates. I haven't been on a first date in a very long time, like a little less than a year, and I just need to get back out there. I think winter's always when I feel like I have this like surge of like wanting to go back on dates. I don't really know why, because you'd think it'd be the opposite, but not even to say I want to like find a boyfriend. I just want to like get comfortable going on more dates and have fun, meet new people, have new experiences, blah blah blah, all that stuff. I feel like I'm like 27, I'm living in New York. Why am I not going on more dates? So that is my goal in 2024, is to go more dates and just be confident and comfortable in myself to do that. Yeah, that's basically that. It's just, you know, it's hard out there, you guys, on the dating apps. Hinge is an interesting place to be. So here's to date in 2024. Sorry, needed my chai tea. Oh my god, I just spilled my chai tea on my jeans. Oh my god, I'm so upset. Okay, we're gonna have to get a tie to go stick for that later. Okay, next up is investing in my clothing. As much as I love Zara, I really want to get away from ordering hauls on Zara unless it's something that I really, really like, because Zara does have really good pieces sometimes and good quality pieces. So, but just like staying away from ordering like huge hauls on like fast fashion and just like spending my money on things that won't last or I'll get rid of in a year. I really want to start investing in like one solid piece instead of a few kind of like more low quality pieces. So whether that's a jacket or a sweater or a pair of jeans I've been really wanting, I feel like it's so much better to invest in one piece that you're gonna have for years. And I find the pieces in my closet that were maybe a little bit pricier or were more of an investment, I wear over and over again, and I can wear them in different ways and with different outfits. So just investing in my clothing, finding new brands I like, not always shopping at the same place, and just like really caring about the quality and what I'm wearing and looking more put together by that. Okay, next up, reading before bed. I was really into reading last year, and I've kind of gone away from it the last couple months because my Kindle actually broke. So I need to order a new Kindle, but I have a few paperback books that I want to read until I can get my Kindle. So just getting better about reading, specifically reading before bed, because I really want to get away from scrolling on my phone and just reading on my and reading in bed before I go to bed. I feel like not staring at a bright screen before going to bed is so much better for you. It helps me sleep better, it helps me go to sleep quicker. And I just love reading. I find like whenever I'm feeling kind of anxious and I pick up a book and read, it like brings me away from being in my head and my own thoughts and like being invested in like the character or like what's going on in the book. I feel like it's just a good distraction. So I mean, I've always been a huge reader, so that might just be me. I know a lot of people aren't really into reading, but I love it. I think I read 35 books this year, which I feel like was good for me because I kind of got away from it ever since graduating college. So gonna get back into reading again once I get my Kindle. Next up, drinking tea. I used to love to drink tea, and especially in the winter, I feel like it's so nice and cozy just have a little warm beverage, and such a nice addition to like a nighttime routine. And I feel like I'm trying to make this like really good quality morning routine that I should do the same thing with my night times, like read a book, make a cup of like peppermint tea. They also have this ginger turmeric tea from Trader Joe's. It's in like an orange package. It's so good. I used to drink that all the time. So just want to get into like things that will make me feel better. Tea is great for you depending on what kind of tea you get, I feel like. So just want to get back into that and just really have a cozy, like healthy, rejuvenating winter. Next up, hot yoga. Yoga is like the one, specifically hot yoga is the one workout that I have probably done for the longest. I used to have a membership back in college and I would go like literally almost every day when I was home in the summer from school. And I just feel like it's the one workout I've always consistently liked and can always motivate myself to get to, because it's not like too crazy. It's not a ton of cardio. It's not like, you know, I mean, it's difficult, but I just feel like I feel so good after doing yoga. And I feel like I do it here and there now. I do it like through ClassPass, so I'll do like a random class every once in a while, but I really want to get into going at least once a week, because just stretching and like spending that time just with myself in a hot, quiet, dark room is so rejuvenating and relaxing. So I want to get more into hot yoga in 2024. Next up are podcasts. I used to be a huge podcast girly and I would listen to them like every day while I was walking or working. And for some reason, I just stopped listening to them. I kind of go in and out of phases of podcasts, but I really want to get back into it. I still listen to, or I try to listen to the daily, like, news podcasts. So I listen to NPR and the New York Times, like, daily, like, 5 minutes, just, like, whatever is going on in the world news that they have. So I listen to those podcasts every day because they're quick, but I want to get more into, like, wellness podcasts or even just, like, a fun one just for, like, myself. But I feel like they have so many, like, hot girl podcasts or like different wellness podcasts. I love the Skinny Confidential. It's like one of my all-time favorites. I like the Blonde Files. I'll listen to Gals on the Go, which sometimes I really want to get into Andrew Huberman, because I really love to listen to the wellness based podcast, because I feel like it's like wellness or business based podcasts I like a lot, because I feel like I feel so productive even though I'm just like listening to something. I feel like I'm like doing something good for myself because I'm like taking tips and like taking like good information in while I'm just like sitting there listening to a podcast. So I definitely want to get back into that, either while I'm going on walks or doing it while I'm working. Gonna be back into podcasts. Oh, I also love true crime podcasts. So like, what's the one that I love? Criminal, or I can't remember what it's called. I think it's Criminal, but I'll link all of these below. And I also love My Favorite Murder for any true crime girls. I can't remember what that one is. I love it. I think it's Criminal. Anyways, doesn't matter. Podcast will just make you feel like you're doing something productive in your day, I feel like. Next up is journaling. I know everyone says like, oh, you should journal more. Everyone loves journaling. And they just feel so much better for it and blah, blah, blah. But like, I put this on my resolutions every year and I can just not get into it. I've tried like the daily, the 5 minute journal. It's just not my thing, I don't think. So I'm just trying my best and trying to do it in a version that like will benefit me. So what I started doing the past couple days or past couple weeks in January is I have my own prompts that I do. So I just write down 3 things that I'm grateful for and 3 things that I'm manifesting. And then I'll also maybe write down like a few sentences or phrases of just like random things that I'm thinking or that I want to manifest or that I want to bring into that day or that week. And if I'm feeling more, then I'll just do like a whole journal, like brain dump, where I'm just like writing out how I'm feeling. So it's not like too much pressure. It'll literally take me like 5 minutes, but I feel like it's just a nice reminder for like listing out some things that I'm grateful for and then also listing out things that I'm manifesting and like that I want to happen in my life. I feel like if you want something to happen in your life, you really do have to manifest it and make it happen yourself. So writing down those bullet points is really helpful for me. Just like a daily reminder of the things that I want to happen in my life. Okay, and then last but not least for my ins is getting tipsy, not drunk, which I've been pretty good about the past couple of months or past couple weeks too, I would say. But you know, I grew up in, I feel like, a big drinking culture, at least in high school and college, and it's just always a part of my life. So I've never not been a huge drinker. I don't really drink during the week. I drink more so socially on the weekends, but I just feel like I'm really trying to get away from feeling like I have to be on the same level as everyone else. It's totally fine if I have a night that I want to like get drunk or have a couple of drinks, whatever, but I want to be better about like thinking about what I want and how I feel, and then instead of like looking at how much else other people are drinking or if other people are drinking. I don't know if that makes sense, but I just want to feel more comfortable being like, oh no, I'm not drinking tonight, but I can still go out and like be out and go to a bar and hang out with people, but like just not feel like I have to drink a lot and not feel like that pressure, which I feel like I always just cave and I'm like, okay, I'll have a drink. So I feel like doing Dry January, which I am doing right now, is a good reminder of that. Like, I can go on a date, I can go out and hang out with friends, I can go to a bar without drinking. And I just feel like that's just something I'm trying to be better about. So my rule for 2024 is getting tipsy, not drunk. So having like maybe only 2 drinks in a night when I go out, or 3 drinks. And just like not having any more than that, because I hate feeling horrible the next morning. I hate being hungover. And it just doesn't make me be my most productive self. I just end up feeling crappy, laying around, maybe not working out, doing whatever, you know? So getting tipsy, not drunk. No judgment if you want to get drunk in 2024. That is on you. You go for it. So those are all of my ins. Now I'm gonna go through my outs. I didn't do as many outs, but just wanted to go through a few. So my first one is a phone scrolling or scrolling on my phone, especially late at night. I need to get off TikTok. I'm obsessed with TikTok lately. Like, I could just be on there for like 30 to 45 minutes, and that's no bueno. So no more TikTok scrolling, and I want to get my phone screen time down. Next is coffee before food. I've been trying to do this for the past like year because I know it's really, really helpful with balancing your hormones and like your stomach, especially too, is not having like that acidic coffee right in the morning, because it really spikes your cortisol levels up. But this one's really hard for me, especially when I wake up early to work out at like 5:30. All I want to do is like go straight away and make a pot of coffee and like have a coffee during my workout. And I'm just finding that that's really leading me to crash in the middle of the day. And I'm having so much caffeine and so much coffee throughout the day when I really don't need it. Especially if I'm getting a good amount of sleep, like I shouldn't need the coffee. So I'm really, really trying to not have coffee before food, or not having coffee for the first hour and a half when I'm awake, either one. So trying to be better about that. I might try to switch to pre-workout instead of coffee, which I know is still caffeine, but I feel like it doesn't really affect me the same way coffee does for some reason. I don't know. That's just like a one that I'm gonna be working on, because I think it's gonna be harder than I think to cut it out completely. But next is negative self-talk. I feel like this year especially, I've been really, really negative on myself and really hard on myself. Physically and like mentally, I feel like I've been so bad about like looking at myself in the mirror and being like, oh, you don't look good, your hair looks bad, your skin looks bad, you know, that outfit doesn't look good on you, the clothes aren't fitting you the right way, or you know, just like kind of making myself, I don't know, just not as confident in myself as I have been in the past. So really want to get better about 2024. No more negative self-talk and like saying nice things about myself. And this also goes into the next one, which is feeling guilty. And I feel like I am negative on myself and hard on myself mentally. And I feel guilty a lot of times, especially for like not being at home with my family, because I'm originally from Kansas City and I now live in New York, obviously. And so I feel guilt a lot of the time not being home and not being there for my family more, which is a huge thing for me. So just trying to let go of all of that guilt and all of that negative self-talk in 2024 and move forward and just like know that I'm doing the best things, the best for me, and I'm doing the best that I can. And yeah, that's all that really matters. As long as you're doing the best you can, you really shouldn't be so hard and negative on yourself. I'm really just like letting it all out in this video, you guys. I hope you're enjoying this. But next is, I had a few more. Why can I not read my handwriting? Oh, next is impulse shopping. Kind of goes along with investment shopping. I want to tell myself that I need to wait 48 hours before buying something, which normally I am pretty good at. But I'm just like over the, oh, 60 bucks here and there. Like, let's just buy this, buy that, buy that. And like, I don't have enough space in this New York studio apartment for that. So I have to like get it together. And really, I want to be more mindful about what I'm buying, what I'm spending my money on. And do I really need it? Can I really style it certain ways? Especially when it comes to clothes. I feel like a lot of times I'm looking for like different outfits or trends, and like, I just need to remember that like the trend's not important. Do I actually like this piece of clothing I'm buying? So just no more impulse shopping. Next and last but not least, following people who don't motivate me. I feel like this goes for anyone. I know like I'm more in social media, so I've probably am on my social media more and I follow a lot more people, I feel like. But just in general, like following people that motivate you to be the best version of yourself, people who inspire you, whether that is like outfits for me, outfit inspiration, maybe it's traveling for inspiration, maybe it's wellness, maybe it's, you know, whatever it is, fitness. Just like only follow people that make you feel good. Don't follow someone who's gonna make you feel bad about yourself and make you feel like you're not doing enough. Yeah, because it's just like, it's not, we spend so much time on our phones and scrolling social media that you really want to make it the most positive, enjoyable experience for yourself. It's not about anyone else. It's about you and your experience scrolling. So I would say go through and really do a good scrub clean of your social media and remove anyone, block them, silence them if you don't want to unfollow them. Just so you don't have to see it. I'm a huge proponent of this, especially like in your personal life, is if there's like an ex-boyfriend or ex-girlfriend, or an ex-friend, or just someone who you find yourself like looking on their social media or something, just block them. We don't need that in our life. I tell everyone this. I'm like, just, you just don't need to, you don't need to be looking at their stuff. And I feel like it really makes a huge difference in our own like well-being and mental health. So I'm just out here blocking people left and right in 2024, so you should too. But that is my list of ins and outs, you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. I really like sitting down, and I feel like doing these kind of sit-down videos really makes me like open up a little bit more and really talk to you guys, and I hope you got to know me a little bit better today. I'd love to do these again. If you like them, please comment below and maybe even comment a few questions you have for me. I can do like a sit-down Q&A, but happy 2024. I hope you guys have the best year yet. I'm so excited for you all. And thank you so much for being here and following me. Don't forget to subscribe. I love my little YouTube family. This has been a huge goal of mine, and I really want to get better about posting on here more in 2024. So here's to that. And love you guys. Thanks so much.